Her mother is worried. He looks out of the window but sees nothing but the dense darkness of night on the black sand of the shore and the dark mountain. Sigdrifa's cat wakes her up by jumping up to the window and scratching the rime frost of the pergament. Opaque windowpane of olden times made of thin, stretched goatskin. Sigdrifa peeps out of the window but sees nothing but the dense darkness of night on the black sand of the shore and the dark mountain. Hugmóður hastily takes on some clothes and rushes outside. He looks for Högni in the place he mentioned, that place between the stones where he fell, but Högni is not there. Hugmóður, in panic, whispers Högni's name, then aloud. Hugmóður falls on the slippery gravel, then rushes back home to the house, wakes up his father and announces, Högni has disappeared. The home folk of Björns walk along the shore, but there is nothing but sleeping seals and silvery rocks to be seen. Gradually some light from full moon lights up the snowy ground. The snow is the only light on long winter nights. Sigdrifa can see from her house that something is wrong. Men on the other farm are systematically searching the shore. She calls out to Hugmóður. They now look each other in the eyes for the first time. Högni has gone missing. Sigdrifa finds Högni's knife, not in the place where he fell. She takes it to Hugmóður. Their eyes meet again in serenity. Högni's little dog, the puppy Askur, eagerly tries to catch attention and leaps, wagging his tail, towards the mountain, trying to have someone follow him. No one pays attention to a playful dog, but everyone is too occupied, searching for Högni to pay attention to that silly doggy. Askur is too young and silly, they seem to think. Yet he seems to be the only one who knows where his beloved Högni has gone, has been taken. The only one who knows, but is not taken seriously. Poor little Iceland. The puppy more intelligent than these settlers. So Askur in vain tries to point out the direction they should look to. Vékell, father to Sigdrifa, comes from the other farm with his men and helps searching. The hopelessness shines from all faces. They look into the open sea, but do not utter a word.